Good morning. We are going to be doing some breath work today and some movement to help us improve our breathing, all in the spirit of consolidation, right? So sometimes we make these gains, improving mobility, improving stability, improving strength. We make gains in the reduction of pain, and it's super exciting. And there's a desire to like want to get out there and just do more. I see this all the time in the early stages of my clients reducing pain. It's like, woohoo! Look at that! I'm there, I can see it, I'm here, I'm out of pain. And then they just go and they push through and do more than they really should. So we're gonna do consolidation today, help you bring your parts that much more connected, integrate your breathing even more so that whatever gains that you've been making, you can really, really, you know, integrate them and then take yourself to the next level. So we're going to be starting in standing. We're going to come down to the floor. You'll see I've got a chair here. We're going to finish off with some sandbag breathing, and partway through, we'll be using a roller, but you don't need a roller. You can always use a block, okay? We'll be putting it underneath our bum. All right, so let's get rolling. We're going to come to standing to begin. So in standing, we're going to begin with tapping and percussion. So I want you to bring your hands together in fists. And you're just going to start, I call this Tarzan breathing as we come up to the chest. But it's commonly called tapping and percussion. Now the thing to remember with this is that it's not, it doesn't have to be regular and consistent. In fact, as you continue to do this, you're going to find that your patterning becomes very irregular. What I do want you to do is I do want you to exhale through your nose or through your mouth. Now, I'm not coming up onto this left side of me because I don't know how the reverberation through the mic is, so I'm going to keep myself down here. But I want you to move through as much of your ribcage as you can, letting that air out. Okay, and then bring that to a close. And then I'd like you to come forward. Place your hands on the top of your knees and we're going to come to lion's breath. You ready? So your tongue is going to come out. So tongue comes way out. If you want, you can look up to your third eye between your eyebrows. Ready? That was kind of a lame one. Let's do that one more time. And now come back up to standing and come into breathing. Now feel yourself in standing and notice the distinction having done tapping and percussion and a little bit of lion's breath. Okay, bring your hands onto the chair and we're going to move into a table. Now you might find that coming to 90 at the hips is too much, so you don't have to. You can come here. You can come to here, right? You don't have to. You choose the place where it makes the most sense. And just easy, easy breathing here. So you want to watch that those ribs haven't gone this way. Yeah. Easy, easy breathing. Okay, and now pay attention to your right elbow, just the right elbow, and I want you to bend that right elbow towards the chair. Bend it and then straighten it. Bend it and then straighten it. And I want you to also feel your shoulder blade. Now your shoulder blade might not move very much, but as you bend your elbow, think about your shoulder blade moving. I don't want you to willfully move it. I just want you to notice if it's moving. Because where it will go is into, hopefully, protraction, not to elevation. And watch that you just don't come into a huge twist when you do this. Right, that just lets you know you're a little bit sticky and stuck. Okay, now let's come to the left side. So bend that elbow. The other thing that tends to happen with people when they're a bit sticky in through that blade, or they're just learning the movement, so they're just getting the coordination pattern, is they'll fall inward. See how my weight's coming off of my feet and I'm coming towards the chair? I'm exaggerating this a little bit, but it's like people will kind of move their whole body in rather than the elbow. So pay attention if you're not only moving that elbow and blade. Okay, good. And then let that go. Perfect. And come up into standing. Now, hands are going to come right beside you. Notice what you're feeling. And then arms are going to rotate out, palms wide. Good. And then arms come up. Good. And then arms come up. And fist your hands for a moment. And then open the hands and then raise them up. Okay? So what's going to start to happen is as you come up, I also want you to think about bringing those arms slightly back into extension. Now you want to be conscientious of yourself here, because we don't want to see those shoulders raise up towards your ear, right? We don't want to see those ribs popping forward. It's really the articulating joint is here at that shoulder. And of course your fingers closing and opening. And you might feel a little bit of a tug. And if it's a little much, then always bring the arms back down, right? We don't have to push through something in order to make gains. It's one of the greatest myths of all time. The idea is developing this inner sense of core of calm, this inner core of calm, this inner sense of ease. That's where I want your movement to arise from. So that then if you are a sprinter, or you are a deadlifter, or you are a like something really powerful kind of movement, you're coming from a core of ease. Yeah, it's like this inner fountain. That's where you're moving from, a core of calm. Yeah, that's what's steady. Yeah, that's what's strong, right? When you can come from that space. Right now, feel yourself in standing. Center of the heel, ball of the foot, and base of the pinky toe. Inner core of calm. Inner core of ease. That might not be at all what's going on inside of you. I get it. Sometimes it's not. That's why I like to throw out the idea of imagine if. Yeah? Because that's ultimately what we're growing here. Right? All this awareness stuff that I'm playing with. Okay, so here. We've done this one before. Oops. You're going to take your elbows onto the chair like this. Now focus on the articulating joints. Shoulders and hips. Yeah? Shoulders and hips. You don't need to grip your abdomen to do this, but you might find that as you move, that your abdomen engages. Yeah? Just easy breath here. Really, really, really easy. Good, good, good. Okay, come back up. Great. Okay, chair can go off to the side. And now, we're going to bring the roller out. Now, you can use a block, because what we're going to do is we're going to lift our pelvis up, and we're going to move roller underneath the pelvis, like so. Okay. So we're just easy, easy, easy breathing. So if you're using the roller, it's placed so you don't feel like it's going to roll forward or roll back. It should be comfortable. And if it's not, lower yourself onto a block. Yeah. And easy breathing.
and lift the hips. I was sharing a quotation from Lao Tzu a while back, I found it a while back, but I was sharing it yesterday with a client, and it's about how water wears away rock, and how what is soft is strong. Yeah. So that's why, really, I see that ease, this idea of ease, really is at the fundamental basis of strength. So often, so what I've done is I just take the sandbag and I place it on the pelvis. Pelvis to abdomen. You know, and so often people move into strength from a place of resistance, of rigidity, right? Of brace, and they anticipate and roar, battle up the horses and roar, take off, where it's like, rather be a ninja. Yeah? Think about that agility that you want to build. As opposed to an anticipatory bracing, which has its place for sure, but I'm not sure it's there every day. So here with the sandbag on your pelvis, gently, gently breathe. And it's in this place of ease where we can really grow our curiosity to see the connections between our parts. Because if you've had persistent pain for any period of time, it's not just one joint that's involved. There's other things and other layers, which as you become aware of them, become very obvious and very simple to work with. But until you're at a place where you can be curious enough about the connections, they aren't so simple to work with. But this place of ease helps grow curiosity, and curiosity helps you see, helps you feel, and helps you be aware. So with that, now just settle in and allow yourself to breathe with the weight of the sandbag, or maybe you've got a bag of rice on your pelvis. And slide the sandbag off, and now just rest here. Noticing what this feels like. And then bring the legs into rotation. So people often call this butterfly, and then bring the legs back together. The feet have not slid in together. They're staying right where they are, and you're coming onto the outside edges of your feet, right? The articulating joint is the leg bone in the hip socket. One more, easy breathing. Bring one knee up. You've moved into hip flexion on one side. Place the hand on the leg. Press the leg into the hand. This is an isometric hip flexion. Try not to brace through your ribs. Let your breath be easy. And then bring that leg down. other leg comes up, press. Be easy, even while your muscles are contracting. Find that play. Find that suppleness. Chances are you have to go a little bit less. Yeah. It's that great idea of less being more, of less being better. Because you move better, you have more efficiency, then everything works better. Easy breathing. Feel the breath fill your belly and your ribcage. Noticing the quality of how the breath comes in and how the breath goes out. Notice when your thoughts come into play and pull yourself back to your breathing. Keep it simple. Back to your breath. Few more breaths, and you can stay here as long as you would like. But if you're ready to move, roll on over and come on up. Easy breathing. And then bring your palms together. Breathe in with ease. And out with gratitude. Namaste. Alright, so allow that consolidation, allow that breath, allow that ease to cultivate. Allow it to turn into that calm, steady, state of being. All right, we will see you tomorrow morning.